Hello and good morning from Proactive New York. With me today is Chairman Terence Cryan of Westwater Resources. Terence, good to meet you. How are you?
I'm very well, Christine. Thanks for having me.
Of course. Terence, for investors new to the story here, give us a quick intro into the company.
Sure. Westwater Resources is an energy technology company. We trade on the New York Stock Exchange American, and we're involved with a couple of pretty exciting projects at the moment. The first one is our advanced graphite materials processing plant, and we broke ground on that last fall. We had a ceremonial groundbreaking last week, actually, in Kellyton, Alabama, with the governor of Alabama in attendance. And, you know, it was a great kickoff for our company. It's an exciting project. And we're going to be providing advanced graphite materials for the electric vehicle, the battery storage, consumer electronics, and industrial markets.
Before we talk more about the processing plan, we did see that President Joe Biden signed a presidential determination to invoke the Defense Production Act. What does that mean for Westwater?
So while we're excited about the announcement, this act was last invoked in the 1950s. So it's been some time, but we're hopeful that it's going to lead for greater support for our projects from the federal government. And that could come in the form of, you know, perhaps loans or grants, aid in terms of permitting. But we're really, you know, still going through that process of really trying to understand what that act will bring to us in the way of benefits.
But it does seem like you're receiving support from the state of Alabama based on your ceremonial groundbreaking.
We've gotten incredible support from the state of Alabama, really since the beginning. And that support is coming in a number of different ways. It's come in the form of a 70-acre land parcel in Kellyton. And that's being done on a lease basis at very favorable terms. And then at the end of 10 years, we get to essentially acquire that land at virtually no cost. It's also, we've also received some significant tax incentives from the state, as well as, commitments to upgrade both the electrical infrastructure as well as the wastewater infrastructure. So, I mean, we just couldn't be more, complimentary about the support we've gotten from the state of Alabama. It's, obviously a hub for automobile manufacturing. A number of the major automobile OEMs have also announced battery plants in the state of Alabama. And as you're probably aware, a lithium ion battery is composed of about 50% graphite. So having a domestic source of graphite right in that automotive belt in Alabama, we think it's going to be very beneficial.
So what are the next few phases now that we should expect from the graphite processing plant?
Sure. So we finished our definitive feasibility study last October, at which point the Westwater Board decided to move forward with construction. The graphite processing plant in phase one is a $202 million commitment. And we're also looking at, expansion beyond that into a phase two. On a sort of parallel path from that, we're also developing our graphite deposit in Coosa County, which is about 30 miles from the site of the processing plant. We control 42,000 acres of mineral rights in the Alabama graphite belt. This is an area that historically has had graphite mining, going back really to the First World War. But there's been no mining of graphite in Alabama really since the 1950s. So we've had a fairly active drilling program at the mine site over the past year. We just recently completed that. And so over the course of this year, we'll be developing the resource model for the mine. Now the mine is scheduled to come into operation in 2028. So you can see we've taken a little bit of a different approach than might be traditional here, where we're developing the processing plant first, and then actually the mine second. And we think there's a number of real meaningful advantages to doing it that way. First is it gets us into production with our advanced graphite materials at a much earlier stage, generating revenue and cash flow. It also allows us to utilize a third-party feedstock of graphite coming from a non-Chinese source supply the phase one of the plant until our mine comes online in 2028. We only get to mine our graphite once, and we think actually in 2028, we'll be able to do that in a higher price environment.
So a lot of activity going on with the processing plant and actually drilling the graphite itself. How well financed are you to do this?
So right now, balance sheet is in great shape. At year end, we had $115 million of cash and zero debt. So, we're for a junior company, small company, I think we're in really good shape to execute on our plan. We will be looking at, raising additional capital for these projects. And we're really, for the processing plant, focused now because we've raised substantial amounts of money in the form of equity and have that cash to invest in the project. We're really going to look at what's available to us in the way of more traditional project financing, straight debt financing, other loans or grants available from government sources. And so we're having all those conversations, in real time with folks, as you would expect us to be doing. So financially, I think we feel good about where we are today and about our ability to fund our plans for the future.
All right. We look forward to following progress. Terence, thanks so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Bye-bye now.